Last thing we did was run the pipe. Now I'm going to show you how to take it out. I guess it's to the inside. I don't know, some people call it the inside or outside. I'm going to take it across my my chest, across my belly. There's a couple ways to do that. I'm going to kind of go over the do's and don'ts. I see some coaches show it, some people show it a certain way, which I don't really like. I think the guy could kick out. But basically, it's this. They get to the leg, right? They come up, they're here. Now, when they go to take it out, they headbutt the guy and slide. All right, so whatever shot they hit, maybe they go, I don't know, knee pull or whatever, right? They come up and they headbutt the guy and slide to take it out, all right? It's okay, but the problem with that is a good guy is gonna point his toe and turn and kick. I wanna keep the leg as tight as possible between my chest and my knee, or my chest and my thigh. So if I come here and I come up and I headbutt, you're gonna kick, and I come here and here, he's gonna turn because it's loose. I really don't like it. It's just, in my opinion, it's just really not good technique. They go here. All right, so here's the don'ts. Here, headbutt, slide. All right, good guys, because you're gonna turn and kick, I'm gonna lose it. All right, so here's what I recommend. All right, this is what I see the best guys in the world doing. They come here, all right? When they come up, they drive, all right? And they go to run the pipe, the guy stays up. I stay down. I don't headbutt and slide, there's space. So when I run the pipe, if he doesn't fall, I'm already in this position. I have his leg locked between my chest and my leg. He can't kick now, all right? And what I do is I slide my leg. I do not do this, all right? I want both feet on the mat at the same time, at all times, if I can help it. Because once my leg comes up, he can hit a cutback on me, all right? And I can go to my back. So if I'm here, he gets a wizard, and I come here, he can go and hit a cutback on me. Just come on the left. I come here, and he falls, boom. All right, that's no good. So what I actually do is I run the pipe, I stay, I step, I slide, and I bring it up. All right, so whatever your shot is, again, I can go knee pull, boom, I come up, I run the pipe, he stays up, I stay down. This is locked, he feels pressure right now. I slide out, I go under, not here, because he'll turn and kick. All right, so it's like I'm a shovel for the heel. All right, so I run the pipe, he stays, I slide out, I go here, and when I come up, I'm gonna swing this thing as high as I can, arch, get on my toes. That's gonna, if I do it hard enough, he might fall, depending upon how tall I am or his balance and flexibility. What it's really gonna do is take him off balance, and it's gonna bring his other foot closer to me, and it's gonna be easier to kick out. All right, because that's gonna be my next finish. All right, so I go single, but I go to run the pipe, and dig, I'm here. I dig, I pull it out. I lock the heel, if I can. This is no good, it's okay. But I don't want to get to here. This is great right here. I lock the heel out, not on the sock. The closer I am to the power source, which is his hip, the stronger he is. So if I'm here, even though it's low, he can still, without even doing that, he can stamp his leg down, there's power there, all right? If I'm at the heel and Koo's bigger and stronger than me, he goes to stamp down, he can't. All right, if I'm here, just a couple inches, sock versus heel, he can start pulling his leg down. Here, no shot. All right, so what I do is I try to get the heel here and I take my forearm alongside his foot and I turn. Now he can't turn and kick. If he goes to try to turn and kick, he can't. All right, he can really injure his MCL or his ankle. All right, so what I do is I run the pipe, I come here, I dig, I pull it out. Watch as I lift, this foot comes to me. All right, nice and tight. Now, what kids do is they try to block, they try to hook. I'm gonna kick this thing just like I'm kicking a field goal. Boom, I'm gonna wind, I'm gonna replace my feet, all my power comes off my back foot. All right, I'm not just trying to kick or step because he's gonna step over me. I'm gonna hop into it and sweep. I try to keep my leg as straight as a board. All right, so I run the pipe, I take it out. As I take it out, I swing, this foot's gonna come to me. As it comes to me, I cross and I kick, boom. There. And I lift and pull him backwards. All right, little trick. Some coaches teach to uppercut the thigh, which is okay. The problem is if he's taller than me or more flexible, this is not going to help much. I actually want to grab the knee and pull him this way. That knocks him off balance. All right, so as I take it out, I pull. When I kick, I'm going to twist a little bit. I pull him to me, this foot comes to his, I kick him. Right, and he hits the mat first. All right, so again, I go arm drag, he faces me, boom, single. All right, I run the pipe, take it out. That's how that foot came to me. I cross, 90, I turn my body 90 degrees. As I take it out, this foot comes to me, I'm already in my cross step. All right, I take it out, I'm already in my cross step. I take it out, cross step, kick, boom. All right, one more time, full speed. Here, bro, and boom, here, on the pipe, I take it out, foot comes to me, boom, kick, falls, I cover.